At the dawn of mankind, reptiles ruled the earth. Less intelligent cavemen were often devoured by these cold-blooded killers, while the higher evolved learned to escape and survived. But the constant threat was relentless. Until at last, one caveman decided enough was enough. It was then that the Slockmaster was born. Man would finally rule the reptiles. Until now. For they are back and hungrier than before. Numbering in the millions, they are causing widespread panic and hysteria throughout the streets of Miami. But fear not, my fellow humans, for the Slockmaster has arrived. And he's got a score to settle. They say he's a wild man who likes to let her fly and say there's no one like him. That, I promise, ain't no lie.
I feel alive when I throw the spear.
For he's a hardcore hunter who kills with stick and strings. Like a croc, he'll wait for hours, 'cause killing's just his thing. He's got a gun, as do most of his friends, but try and take it from him, and you'll likely wind up dead. He hunts with spears and blowguns, but he loves to shoot his bow. And when his arrow cuts the distance, the blood begins to flow. He trained his kids to hunt, so that's just what they do. They're lethal with a bow, and their mama's deadly too. Critters tried to kill him, and he nearly killed himself. But dying's for dead men, and that card ain't been dealt. He's still out there living. The guy who lets her fly, he'll probably be shooting arrows the day he finally dies. So if you're searching for a killer, the baddest predator beneath the sun, you can stop your looking, for you just found him. I'm the one. Today we are in Florida, where iguana populations are at an epic level. The hunt is on, and if all goes as planned, we will leave this place with skins and some of the best white meat in the world. But more so, we will return the natural balance back to the streets and waterways of South Florida. I'm armed with the deadly Slockmaster blowgun, so let's let the hunt begin.
He's going up.
How we going?
We're rolling.
We rolling? So we're rolling. We just cut our first clip here in Florida, and a lot of rumors in Florida down here about sex trafficking. So we want to make sure we get some video of me before I go out with these guys, because I don't know them too well, and we want to make sure, as long as if you find the camera, you don't find me, you know what happened to me. But Donovan?
I'm going
to
be rich.
Okay. We are after them. And JP says he's skeptical about the blowgun because he's a professional iguana hunter. So tell us a little bit about what we're about to do, guys.
So what we're going to be doing is we're going to find these iguanas. They're getting ready to start coming out and sunning. Now it's starting to be the warmest part of the day. They're going to get up on the rocks and basking some in it, on the top of the limbs, right on the edge of the branches. We're going to see some really big orange iguanas, some green iguanas. May find some black spiny tails if they're in here. But my buddy JP is probably the best expert in iguanas, so I brought him along.
All right. And what's his?
He's the fan.
All right. He was making America great again, or hunting great again. So stick with us. When we get back, we'll be slocking an iguana with the blowgun, or a bow, boomerang, who knows? Maybe we'll throw JP in and he can swim up and bite one with his teeth.
Nice.
Nice, yes. All right, here we go.
Don't try to be like me, for I'm old, crazy, and have nothing to lose. Brought to you by SKB, keep your travels safe. Bass Pro, Oneida Bows, and Mossy Oak, Relentless Pursuit's first choice in camouflage.
All right, well, here we are in Florida, obviously, and you can hear jets flying over from above. I can hear cars in the distance, but it's just a jungle along these waterways. These iguanas are here literally by the millions. They're hundreds of square miles that they inhabit now, an invasive species, a real problem for Florida, much like the python. But what we're doing is we found that there's a good concentration of them along all these waterways. These are irrigation waterways, these are rivers. Anywhere there's water, they concentrate along the edge because they can be safe above the water where predators can't get at them. If you look up ahead of me here in the mangoes, you can see big ones sleeping in the trees. There's even one down low here. So it's a target-rich environment, I can tell you that. Ooh, and there's a big orange one right here. Look at that giant orange one right there. Right there. See him?
We hadn't gone 30 yards off the dock when Donovan spotted a giant lurking in the trees. Soaking up the morning sun, he seemed out of place in this garden of beauty. But he wasn't alone. And in no time, we were looking at monsters on both sides of the river. Ugly, yet beautiful. I was quite intrigued. Because these reptiles are so strong, JP was a skeptic. So we gave him the first go-round with my blowgun. With a good hit, the mighty lizard was off and running. Then, to my amazement, he made a jump for it. And even more amazing, they can swim. And boy, are they good at it. This was going to be a real test for my blowgun setup. But so far, so good.
There you go, that's my first iguana I ever shot with a blowgun. And I gotta tell you, it worked awesome. These things are phenomenal. I had my reservations when Tim talked about it, and I can tell you, without any hesitation, these things are awesome. You see, that's a clean pass through on the vitals with that dart. And I am no experienced blowgun guy by any means, so I'm impressed with that.
The Everglades are now infested with invasive species. They threaten the natural ecosystem. snakes, fish, plants, and of course, iguanas were all introduced by us. Humans, of course, and it's ironic that hunters are the single most effective means of returning the balance back to this fragile environment. Even so, many oppose hunting, and despite the good it brings, constantly threaten the culture of hunting.
This was almost a fluorescent green one. He's out here in the open where I can get a good shot at him. If we don't spook him and he doesn't turn and run, I may have him.
I'm hoping to leave with some of their beautiful skins and delicious white flesh. It's a vital hit, but like snakes and other reptiles, it takes time for the dart to put the lights out. My string attached to the dart acts like a tracking system. When the reptile retreats, he often gets tangled. If not, I can follow the string into the quagmire of brush and find him.
Barring there's not a python in here waiting for me, I have managed to get my iguana that was lethally hit. You can see the penetration was beautiful. You couldn't put an X on him and hit him any better. His muscles have tensed up like all reptiles, but another beautiful iguana. I've got snake skin, or iguana skin. And look at the skin on the tail. Won't that be amazing when you take that off of him? All right. Having a great time down here with my guide Donovan, who has put me on iguanas.
And I can promise you, I'm having the time of my life. I'm glad you could join me.
Thank you.
Young iguana tries to escape, but he's hooked by the dart and becomes entangled, then falls into the water where we retrieved him.
Water. I got him, boy, and that's a green one. I wanted a green one bad.
He tried to run. He was running up the limb, trying to get away from me, but I just put one right over the top of his hind leg, in through his vitals, and out the other side.
There we go.
Yeah, look at that. Oh, man. What a beautiful trophy. Now that's some skin for the bow limbs that's going to be just absolutely beautiful. And he's a young one too. He's probably good to eat. He's a little wrapped up there. Oh, we're going to lose my dart, but that's okay. Well, you can see the very vital hit, but the reptiles are tough. So when we get them in the boat, we bonk them on the head like a tree frog or like a bullfrog, and that's it. Dilly dilly. We're doing it today here in South Florida.
If they sense pain when hit by the dart, they sure don't act like it.
Oh, grab him. Go, get lower on his body. Lower on his body.
Oh, my God.
Now that is a beautiful species right there. Look at that. We got an iguana down here in Florida, and it couldn't be more happy. Look how beautiful the colors are on this guy. He's got orange, and look at that. Wow, what an amazing animal. Delicious, too. This is, I'd say he probably weighs about what, 6-7 pounds, yeah, 8 maybe?
I'd push him, I think 8 pounds.
Yeah, probably. Man, look at that.
Yep.
Oh yeah, little guy. But man, look at the skin on him. Isn't that beautiful, how green that is? Wow, that's the exciting stuff.
Do you own a blowgun or spear? Well, Slockmaster.com is where they're sold. We've got the best razor darts, blowguns, fishhawks, and spears right here at Slockmaster.com. They're just too much fun. Pick off a squirrel or rabbit while you're waiting on a deer, and bring home some hassan pepper for dinner. By golly, at Slockmaster.com, we sell the perfect gift. So check us out at Slockmaster.com.
I'm having the time of my life. Give me a blowgun and send me in the woods, and I'm as happy as a little kid in a candy store. We're on another one, and it's a big red one. Big male. He's showing his colors.
I was having so much fun, I decided to put Donovan behind the gun as well. I wanted to see how he could do. He was a stuntman for the Spider-Man movies, and I was about to be very impressed. Keep watching. I think you will be too.
Oh, he's getting away. He's going
yeah,
up.
Hold the line.
He's going up.
Go. Oh my.
Whoa, yeah. That's Iguana Man for you right there. You got him, buddy. You got your iguana. Took a couple darts and a frog leap off the boat, but he has scored here in South Florida. Boy, look at that beautiful thing. Isn't he beautiful? Wow. Now the males give you the big orange colors, and they're mating this time of the year. You can see that it's just an iridescent, beautiful orange color, and that's a good shot.
But even a better leap off the front of the boat.
Oh my.
We've even seen a white buzzard setting in the trees above us. That's a first for me.
If you look up ahead of me here, in the mangoes, you can see big ones sleeping in the trees. There's even one down low here. So, it's a target-rich environment, I can tell you that.
Atta boy,
nice.
10 ring.
Oh, come on, back with the boat. Full
you're like a stinking aborigine with that blowgun, buddy.
Look at the blue head on that.
Yeah! Woo-hoo! What a shot, buddy!
Woo! Look at that.
Very
right
nice.
There. Perfect shot. And so you think about every one of those is an egg of an iguana that really doesn't have a natural predator out here. All these iguanas that we took today don't really have any natural predators. So all those are gonna turn into more iguanas that are gonna eat up the natural vegetation. So taking out that iguana right there, we just knocked down about 30 more iguanas.
From everything I know about these, you know, when the Hurricane Andrew came through, you know, we had a big problem down in Homestead. They had large warehouses full of a lot of exotic pets. So when Andrew came through and devastated everything, everything got loose. Not to mention people get iguanas when they're small, they get big, they can't handle them, they don't want them anymore, so they just let them loose.
This guy's a meat eater, the black Mexican rock iguana and the common green iguana. Both are out of control.
and they just keep reproducing and reproducing. Like Donovan said, they don't have natural predators, so they have nothing to even them out, the environment, so they just keep going and going and going. The next thing you know, you're going down the canal and there's hundreds of them.
A country boy can find a use for anything, especially beautiful skins and snow white meat.
Ooh, that green one's gonna be beautiful. The skin on that belly, wow.
Very beautiful, at least to me it was.
I got him, I got him. And it's right in the vitals. Look at the blood coming out. Oh man, he's strong.
This braided line will hold him though.
There's the killing dart right there. It doesn't look like much, but you can dispatch a beast like this with it. Actually, that thing will kill a whitetail. It's just all about dart placement. You wait for the animal to give you the perfect shot, and you put it right in the vitals. Ha! They say they taste like chicken. Well, we're gonna find out.